Hello everyone and welcome back to my Let's Play of Dr. Muto. And we are currently at the sphere ending because very close to here is the first Terra piece I want to collect, and that's number 6, which is Ring Wrangled. Owl's Ring Course version 2.0. Very difficult, like LA freeway driving. Now, when we were last here, you saw me try this and I failed miserably. So, just to refresh our mind, let's speak to Al again and see what he said.
So, as you can see, you're way up here on the top of the sphere, and I've got a new challenge for you. It's worth some Terra. I've just written some very difficult software that controls a ring course for this area. Want to give it a try?
Why not?
Let's get it on.
Okay. Now I might miss on this first go because I need to morph into the bat first. As you can see, didn't give me enough time. So we'll just speak to Al again.
So as you
quickly.
Let's get it on.
And retry that. This time we're ready. Let's see how we do. I've noticed this one you need to turn a bit so that you're facing that way. And I think I missed. Yes, I did. Okay, so we're going to try that again. While not overly difficult, there are a few things you need to keep in mind. And that's not to come to a sudden halt on a platform. Or to smash into a platform. Because that could cost you like that, for instance. Now, if you make an error, you can actually correct yourself. But you don't have to fly through it. You can just touch it like so. And I'm going all over the place, except the right place. Okay, so we're going to try that again. And it took me many tries to do this. And even then, it's a bit of luck as well, because of the platforms and how well you can dodge them in time. So far so good, but we're not even halfway there yet, so. Okay, so now it's going to get a little trickier. Ah, there, see, that corner there. Right, we're nearly there. Come on. And there we go. That's the hardest Terra piece of the sphere. So we'll grab that one now. Don't know what he's doing there, but okay, cool. Strike a pose. All right, so what can we do now? Let's have a look. So we've got quite a few isotopes to get. It's 85 we need, and one DNA. I suppose we could fly around and look for some isotopes and possibly the last of the DNA. We can do the last Terra piece on our way to the cube, because once you go past that, you'll end up in the cube anyway. So, and this actually involves going through that huge tube with those, I think they're mines. But you'll see that when I get there. Thanks to Van Bacon for pointing that out to me, because I hadn't a clue what this was. So, we'll see it eventually. Alright, so let's go isotope hunting. It's probably best to start at one spot and just work your way around, like here, for instance. And just keep going around in a circle, and eventually we'll find them. If it gets too boring, I'll probably cut some out and just show you the relevant snatching of isotopes. Some of them are quite hard to see, actually. And I think I missed one on the right there. But we'll go back in a circle anyway, so sort of work our way up, and then we'll do the inside of the sphere. And there's some a little bit of frustration there, but you'll see that when we get there. So there's one here. Mostly these isotope clusters, and they give 5 isotopes, which really helps in getting the 400 that we need. I'm not quite sure how many we've got now. Alright, so what I'll do is I'll go off screen and then just fly around, and you'll see me when I reach them. So I'll see you then. Oh, here's one. Oh, and here's the last of the DNA. There we go. Whoops. Alright, so there's a crate here, and an enemy that just morph out. Get rid of him. There we go. There we go. Alright. Fly again. Oh, there's a Goma crate here, so let's find the Goma. I think there's one over there. Yeah. Come with me. There we go. Alright. 365. Alright, so we're inside the sphere now. There's a crate. And here's another. Oh, that's only got one isotope. Okay. Alright, so if we go through here, there's a ramp leading up. And underneath this ramp here are 3 Goma crates, which you might have seen in a previous episode. And if we look up here, there's a Goma, a couple of isotopes on that side, and a couple of isotopes on that side. Now we need to fly up to that ledge just above the Goma so that we can snag it from there and then jump down onto the wall here and then down onto the floor here. But that's easier said than done, because we don't have a lot of flying room, and more often than not, once we start flying, it's more than likely halfway up we'll transform back into Dr. Muto. But we'll see how it goes, and if it takes too long, I'll do it off screen. So let's give this a go and try. See? Alright. Try that again. And there we go, we're up on top now. Thing is, we need to get over to where the Goma is. Can't really see him. So I'm just gonna fly. Oh, there he is. That's weird, that